Greetings, everyone. My name is Stefan Sorger. I'm an instructor for data analytics and other courses. I'll be taking you some basic first steps to learning the R programming language. We've made every effort to ensure accuracy and relevancy of the content. Nevertheless, we cannot control how the information is being used, so we assume no liability for the use of this information. In this presentation, I'll take you through some basic first steps in learning R, including getting R, learning basic functions, getting help, and loading data. To start, we will open up a search engine and type in download R. In this case, I'm using a Windows platform, so I'll be clicking on Windows. If you're using Mac, you would click on the Mac listing instead. Now I'm going to click on the latest version. It's going to download it. This will take just a couple of minutes. I've decided to show you the real-time version, just so you have an idea about how it's actually done. So you'll see it'll go through all the steps. Yes, and yes, and just say yes to everything. Yeah, that looks good. That looks fine. It'll start downloading it. You'll see the progress on here. Once this is done, I will launch R by double-clicking on the icon or going to the menu bar and clicking on it, depending on your own computer's interface. In this case, I'm using Windows 10, so I would just go to the menu bar and click on R. It's just about done, so I'm going to finish it. I'm going to go to the menu. And here I'm going to resize it so we can see it a little better. Again, I've made the conscious decision to actually do this in real time as opposed to having this all ready for you ahead of time. That way you can see exactly how this process works. And this is called the R console. You can see on the top, there's a few commands here on the files. But that's not where the power is. The power is in this command line interface. So let's do some basic commands to get ready. I'm going to type in 2 plus 3. And you can see it said two things. The first one is this 1 in brackets. That's the first line of output. And you can see it's giving me the number 5. So now let's see how we load some basic data. So there's two ways to do this. We can enter it in directly, or we can load it through an external source such as Microsoft Excel. I'm going to enter it in directly first. So now to do that, I might put in a vector, maybe 1, 2, and 3, put in a vector of the values 1, 2, and 3, and I'll call that y. So I would say that. And now instead of an equal sign, we use an assignment operator. And that's depicted through a left facing arrow that we enter in as a less than sign, and then a dash, and then the letter C, which stands for combine. That's how we make a vector in R. So I'm going to hit enter. And so now I'm going to type the letter Y, and it'll show me what's in Y, which is 1, 2, and 3. And now we can do some work on it. We can say, well, what's the mean of Y? That's the average. What's the median of Y? Maybe what's the standard deviation of Y? So how would you know what these functions were? Well, you can learn it as you go along, or you can get a R reference card, which includes 4 pages of common R functions. Just search for R reference card on a search engine. If you need help with R, just type a question mark with the functions you need help on. For example, I just did mean. What if I did question mark mean? Up will pop an internet browser window with information on mean. And here you can see it's given me some information on mean. It includes the description, usage, the arguments of mean, and some other information. Instead of a question mark, I could also type in help mean. And it does the same thing. Here we see the arithmetic mean again. So either of those two ways are fine. We're going to move on now to loading data in R. It's a three-step process. The first step process is we need to tell R where it can find the files, because it doesn't know. So we tell the directory to R by using the change directory command. For Windows machines, we click on File. For Mac machines, we click on MISC. So this is Windows, so I'm going to click File and change directory. Then you're just going to find wherever you put your files. So I put it in Files. So that's the folder where I have my files, so I'm going to click OK. And now R knows where it is. With that done, now I need to check my Microsoft Excel file to make sure it's ready to go. So I'm going to open up Microsoft Excel. And then I'll show you what the file looks like. So here we have a file that I've already created, just a regular Microsoft Excel file. This top row is sometimes referred to as the header row. And we want to make sure there's nothing on top of it, you know, no explanatory information. And this one doesn't have it, so we're good. Also, in this header row, I want to make sure there's no special characters like exclamation points or anything like that. And there isn't, so that's good. Then the third step we need to do is save it as a CSV file, a comma separated values. So save as. We go in here, we find comma delimited. Then we click OK. Then Excel's going to make me go through a little dance here. That's all fine. And what I'm gonna do is take that file I just showed you. I called it sample data, and I'm gonna put it in a variable I'm gonna call x. So x, and I'm gonna read in that CSV file with a function called read.csv. So read.csv. Then the name of the file is sample data, and it's a CSV file, so I'm going to put in CSV. And it does have a header row. I did check that, and so I'm going to say that's true. Then I'm going to hit enter. And now I don't know if it read it in or not, so I want to verify it. So I'm going to type in X just to see what's in X. So I just type in X, and it shows me. That's a lot of data, and I'd have to scroll through it. So to avoid scrolling through all that data, if I want a summary of it, I can hit the summary command. So summary of X, and that'll show me a statistical summary. And here's a statistical summary showing the mean and all that. Another way to do it is look at the structure of the data, how many variables and so forth. So I can hit structure, and that'll give me the structure of the data set. There's the structure showing all the variables. And that will tell us then how to make sure we've loaded the data in properly. Again, four things we looked at today, which were to download R, to do some basic functions, getting help, and loading data for Microsoft Excel. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, please subscribe to the channel. We will have future videos on data visualization and all sorts of other topics. Thank you.